All right, so we have moved on from the those issues relative to winning the primary versus general elect versus general election. We're going to move on to some other issues relative to campaigning for political office, again with the focus being primarily the president. So one of the things that happens in our modern world is campaign spots. What we mean by this is TV commercials, and as we said in one of the earlier slides, it is ironic that negative campaigning works. It just tends to work. We've moved in really into a new era in with this with TV, the mass media. It's changed. It's changed everything relative to what happens with the president and the elections. So what we want to do right now, we want to take a look at this by having you, and this should set now say 23, not 22. We want you to get a piece of paper, a scratch piece of paper, number 1 through 23 on your scratch piece of paper. You can pause this while you do that, and then you're going to rate. I'm going to show you 23 individuals, and you're going to rate them 1 through 10. 10 is attractive, and 1 is not. Or you can rate them somewhere in between. And this all has some bearing. We're going to go through it kind of fast. So there's the first one. How would you rank JFK? 10 being hot, 1 not, or anywhere in between. Make a quick decision. Now we move on to the next one. LBJ. How would you rank him? Richard Nixon. How would you rank him? So what you hopefully what you're doing is you've written 1 through 23 on your paper, and then next to 1, which is for John F. Kennedy, you've put what you would rank him as, a 10, a 9, an 8, whatever it is. And this will all make sense later on. So now we're on Richard Milhouse Nixon. Next to 3, if you think he's a 7, put a 7, etc. Moving on now, Gerald Ford, how would you rank him? Jimmy Carter, how would you rank him? 10 is hot, 1 is not, somewhere in between. Ronald Reagan, how would you rank him? Be honest in your appraisals. Don't think, oh, this guy's, I don't like this guy because of his politics, therefore rank him lower because of that. So just be honest, otherwise this won't make any sense. George Bush the first, how would you rank him? Now what I've tried to do is try to get their campaign pictures on these. This is not his campaign picture, but nevertheless, there it is. Okay, so I wasn't able to get it for everybody. William Jefferson Clinton, how would you rank him? 10 hot, 1 not. George W. Bush 43, because he was the 43rd president of the United States. How would you rank him? Barack Obama, where would you rank him? 10 through 1. Donald Trump, where would you rank him? All right, now we're going to get to some other figures that you may not recognize. Walter Mondale, what would be the rank for him? Barry Goldwater, how would you rank him? Don't let the style of the glasses influence it, although these glasses have made a comeback, so maybe that won't influence you. John Kerry, how would you rank him? Hubert Humphrey. How would you rank him? Al Gore, what would be his rank? Michael Dukakis, what would be his rank? John McCain, what would be his rank? Again, make quick judgments. George McGovern, what would be his rank? Robert Dole, what would be his rank? Mitt Romney, what would be his rank? Hillary Clinton, what would be her rank? Not a lot of good pictures of her out there, so I tried to, again, this is her official. I tried not to do any ones with had their campaign paint next to them, but this was the best one of her. I didn't want to put a lousy one up her and think I was trying think have you think I was trying to influence things, what was going on there. And finally, Joe Biden, how would you rank him? Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to compare individuals that ran against each other in presidential elections. So look at what you gave John F. Kennedy. He was your position one versus what you gave Richard Milhouse Nixon. My guess is you ranked him as better looking than you ranked Richard Milhouse Nixon. And what do you know? John F. Kennedy won. What does that mean? We're going to get to that. Look at what you gave for number two, Johnson, versus for what you gave for Goldwater. And my guess is most of you, of course, will never know. But if you're like my previous classes, most of you ranked Lyndon Baines Johnson as better looking than Goldwater. Look at what you gave for Humphrey versus what you gave for Nixon. And my guess is most of you would have ranked him as better looking, and interestingly enough, he won. Again, interestingly enough, Johnson won, not Goldwater. Okay, moving on. Carter versus Ford. Look at what you gave for five versus what you gave for four. And Carter won. Who was better looking in your analysis, Carter or Reagan? Reagan won. Reagan won. It seems like the better looking person tends to win. Again, look at what you gave for six versus what you gave for 12. Chances are you ranked him as better looking than you ranked him. If you didn't, maybe you should get your eyes checked. Same idea here. This one's tough. Not a very good picture, but this swarthy little guy just. I'd be really be interested if we were in class to see where you'd rank these guys. Interestingly enough, Bush won. Up, oh, skipped one. Here we go. Carter, excuse me, Clinton versus Bush. Most people would probably think he's better looking, and he wins. He wins. Number eight. What'd you get for number eight? What'd you get for 20? Chances are you ranked him as better looking, and he won. This one, it's interesting. I would, based on this picture and this picture, I would say maybe he's better looking, but this would be my, but in person, just maybe this just wasn't a very good picture. This is his actual presidential picture. So not that every better looking candidate wins, but by and large, that seems to be what's happening in this modern media era that we're living in. So let's move on to this election right here. Bush versus Kerry. Bush wins in most of my classes. Bush gets higher ranks as far as looks than Kerry does. Obama versus John McCain. Obama gets better rankings than John McCain does, just the way it was, and boom, Obama wins. And this one, I think he's an attractive guy. He's the sitting president. He wins, he doesn't. So it's not as easy as to who's the better looking candidate and they'll win. But as you've seen from all these previous examples we have given you, that scent tends to be what the case is in these other issues right here. Certainly not in all of them. As we've seen here, there's other factors than just who's better looking, but it's amazing how often that comes into play. Who's better looking? This one's tough to say. This one's tough to say because you're comparing a woman to a man. In a couple of classes thought she was better looking there again, but the thesis in a sense holds true as she won the popular vote. It'll be interesting to see what happens at the end of 2020 if there actually even is an election. Who's better looking? It'd be, really be interested to know who you put as better looking, Biden or Trump. There's some, again, other issues going on. Some people are arguing. I heard some disc jockeys on the radio the other day think that Joe Biden has some dementia, and his outbursts are signs of that. So it'll be interesting if he can control that. I'm not saying he does have dementia, the beginning stages of dementia. It'll be interesting to see if he can control that, if he can control his temper. If he can't control his temper, that's certainly going to play into the election. And if in fact the election doesn't get postponed because of the coronavirus, an election, to my knowledge, has never been postponed. But then we have never been going through a pandemic when an election is going on. So what you should have learned from all this is, in our modern media era, and yes, there's a question on the exam for this, so it's taken us 10 minutes for you to understand this question. In the modern media era, It tends to be that the better looking candidate wins. Again, it is not always the case, but that is certainly a factor. If you go back to the first Back to the Future, Marty, or actually it's the second Back to the Future where Marty wakes up in Doc Brown's house and tries to convince him that tries to convince Doc Brown that he's from the future, and Doc Brown asks him, "Who's president in 1985?" And Marty just right away says, "Ronald Reagan." And Doc Brown responds incredulously, "Ronald Reagan, the actor?" And then later on, he realizes that Marty is from the future, and he's taken a look at that video recorder, and he says, "No wonder your president has to be an actor in 1985 because he's got to look good on TV." And there is a lot of truth to that. You've got to have this image to where previously you didn't have to have that image. For ex one last example, and then I'll stop with this and we'll move on. It is said by historians that FDR, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, never would have been president of the United States in the modern media era, because most people didn't even know that he was in a wheelchair, because of his childhood polio. And that's what historians say. So again, it bears fruit to this thesis that you've got to look good, you've got to look presidential, to win the office in the modern media era.